Hi everyone, I'm Kevin Elson for Catholic News Break. Here's what's happening this week in the news. We begin from the Vatican. The Vatican has announced Pope Benedict XVI has transferred Italian Archbishop Giuseppe Lienza from his post as ambassador to Ireland to nuncio to the Czech Republic. The Archbishop had been nuncio to Ireland since February of 2008, but was temporarily called back to the Vatican in late July. In early July, the Irish government's Cloyne report was released, and it examined how the Diocese of Cloyne mishandled accusations of clerical sexual abuse. The report also accused the Vatican of being entirely unhelpful to Irish bishops seeking to implement robust abuse policies. The day after the report's release, Ireland's foreign minister, Eamon Gilmore, summoned the archbishop, demanding a formal response from the Vatican. The foreign minister told the archbishop that the Vatican had opposed the Irish bishop's 1996 guidelines for handling child sexual abuse and supported those within the church who did not want to implement the procedures. The Vatican issued its response to the report in early September, denying it undermined the Irish bishop's efforts to protect children. In other news from the Vatican, the prefect of the Congregation of the Doctrine of the Faith met with the head of the Society of St. Pius X to discuss a doctrinal preamble the Vatican is issuing to the organization. Also, the Pope held his weekly general audience, speaking to 8,000 pilgrims on the importance of reaching out to God in a time of great need. Catholic News Service's Carol Glatz has more on these two stories.
Here at the Vatican, there was an important closed-door meeting between Cardinal William Levada, the head of the Vatican's doctrinal congregation, and Bishop Bernard Fillet, head of the Traditionalist Society of St. Pius X. After the meeting, Father Lombardi, director of the Vatican Press Office, told journalists that Cardinal Levada gave Bishop Fillet a doctrinal preamble. It's a statement of doctrinal principles the Society must agree with in order to guarantee their unity with the Church. Father Lombardi said that while the Vatican did not give a firm deadline, an official response from the traditionalists is expected within a few months. Now, also at the Vatican, Pope Benedict held his weekly general audience here this morning, and he continued his series of talks about prayer. Today he turned to Psalm 22 with its famous opening, my God, why have you abandoned me?" The Pope said the psalm teaches that even when God seems absent or silent, believers must remember God's fidelity. They must trust that Christ has ensured that suffering and death will not have the last word.
Looking now at news from around the world, Djibouti Bishop Giorgio Bertin said recently that he was happy that hundreds of displaced Somalis were using the ruins of the Mogadishu Catholic Cathedral for a home. Bishop Bertin, who oversees Catholics in neighboring Somalia, said the cathedral, which has not been used since it was ransacked and set on fire in 1991, is one of hundreds of camps for displaced people in Mogadishu. The UN has declared a famine in parts of Somalia, including the capital city. Since 1991, Somalia has endured a civil war, and famine-hit areas are plagued by a weak central government and the presence of various political factions that control parts of the country. The instability and violence severely limit the delivery of humanitarian assistance. Hundreds of thousands of Somalis have been forced to flee to Kenya. In 1989, Italian-born Bishop Pietro Salvatore Colombo of Mogadishu was killed at his cathedral. After the murder, the Vatican eliminated the post and now oversees Somalia through neighboring Djibouti. And finally in the news, the Vatican's foreign minister speaking out on religious freedom, saying it includes allowing believers to contribute to their country's political discussions and to allow their beliefs and morals to impact the way they engage in public life. Archbishop Domenico Mamberti, the Vatican Secretary for Relations with States, says efforts to ban religious expressions from public life are an attack on religious freedom. The Archbishop made his remarks at a recent meeting in Rome, sponsored by the Organization for Security and Cooperation in Europe, that focused on preventing the responding to hate crime incidents and crimes against Christians. And the organization's Office for Democratic Institutions and Human Rights has reported a growing intolerance of Christians. Acts against Christians include desecration of places of worship, arson and other property damage, and attacks on worshipers and religious leaders in the organization's 56 member states, which include most European countries as well as the U.S. and Canada. Archbishop Mamberti said religious freedom cannot be simply freedom of worship. It must also include the right to preach, educate, convert, contribute to political discourse, and participate fully in public activities. Well, that is all the information we have for you at this time. Please stay with Catholic TV for more Catholic news. Until then, I'm Kevin Nelson, and I'll see you next time on Catholic News Break.